Algunos youtubers que te pueden llegar a interesar, ya sea por su creatividad, por sus detalles técnicos o porque simplemente a veces mueren en un directo, tal como Miguel Gamer, que ha conquistado el corazón de muchos de sus suscriptores gracias a veces a que muere en directos.
Yo no
Pero
mando
realmente lo
saludos a
felicito
nadie.
porque ha
Como es tu gato, le voy
logrado
a mandar un saludo a tu gato de una
monetizar
forma
su
espectacular en
canal,
este momento.
hacerse un
El domingo
sueldo
para
gracias
darme.
a las donaciones y
¡No
a
te lo
las
puedo creer!
membresías
¡Me
de la
volvieron
gente que
loco!
lo sigue. Así que
¡Dios!
realmente felicitaciones, muy buen trabajo.
¡Empate! ¡No! ¡No te lo puedo creer! ¡No te lo puedo creer! ¡No puedo ser tan subnormal! Acabo de perder mis picos, mi pala, mi hacha, mis dos picos, mis botas de caída de plumas super tochas. Porque el agua la va a llevar. Todo, todo perdí. Dos Shulker Box. No lo puedo creer. Que a tu gato la saludamos, o sea. Gata Changa, te mando un saludo muy especial de Miguel Gamer. Si quieren pueden spamear el emoji de la F. Si quieren. Si quieren pueden hacerlo, se les permite. Esa F no me está gustando. Se están pasando con las Fs. Que se están pasando con las Fs. No te lo puedo creer. Me están amenazando. No te lo puedo creer. Me voy haciendo una forma y me hace una cosa de loco. Pero que paren con las Fs. Que paren. Es una cosa de loco, esto no para, es un mar de Fs. No pasa nada, no pasa nada. Uno acá dándolo todo. Dándolo todo. He perdido Shulker Box y me cago en la. Uno acá dándolo todo. No para, pero por Dios, paren con las Fs, Dios mío, y la Virgen Santísima. Yo no te lo puedo creer. Mirá, encima estamos. Acá no está el planeta Junior, que el planeta Junior. Si hubiera estado, los baneaba a todos. Es una cosa de loco. Puedo creer. No te lo puedo creer. No creo que no haya otra forma distinta de volarse. Es que, ¿qué otra cosa puede hacer aparte del F? No te lo puedo creer. ¿Qué pasó? ¡Pero pare con las F, carajo! Juanca Chávez ha donado 39 pesos mexicanos. ¿Y qué puso en su mensaje? Para que se me pasó algo. ¡Puso una F, el desgraciado! ¡Juanca puso una F también! ¡Que pare con las Fs! ¡Que me puso una F! Emojis exclusivísimos para los miembros. Los quiero ver, Dino Rex. Los quiero ver. Los quiero ver. Dino, por Dios. Mostrá esos emojis que se aprecian y respetan. ¡No, te lo puedo creer! ¡No! ¡No, no, no! ¡No! 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 ¡Te lo puedo! ¡No! No voy a voltear mi cabeza a ver ese monitor. No te lo puedo creer. No voy a ver el chat. A ver, a ver. Voy a poner mi. A ver, estoy con los ojos cerrados en este momento. Voy a mirar hacia la. ¡Oh, hijo de puta! Es una lluvia de Fs. Es una lluvia de Fs. No te lo puedo creer. No te lo puedo creer. La lluvia de F son unos desgraciados. No te lo puedo creer. puede ser. Es que no puedo morir tantas veces en un solo directo. No puedo morir tantas veces. No puedo perder tantas cosas juntas. Y ahora, anda a volver a este lugar. Anda a volver. No, te lo puedo creer. No, te lo puedo creer. ¿A dónde estaba?
Dale bien para Juan Ignacio. Miguel, me encantó el video de los hongos. Soy nuevo en el canal, YouTube me recomendó. Aquí video, espero más. Dice Tomás. Tomás, muchísimas gracias por ese comentario. Yo te espero a ver también a vos seguido en la caja de comentarios, ya sea en los directos y también en los videos, ¿sabes? Gracias por estar en el canal. Gracias por haberte suscrito. Gracias por elegir este canal para pasar esta noche. De verdad, de corazón, muchísimas gracias. Único requisito para poder estar en este directo, los directos de medianoche, buena onda, nada más, tranquilidad. Acá no venimos con apuro, Minecraft técnico, cosas complejas en los videos. Acá venimos para pasar... ¡Pero bueno! ¡No! ¡No! ¿Por qué? ¿Pero por qué? ¿Por qué? ¿Pero por qué? ¿Qué pasó? ¿Pero qué pasó? ¿Pero por qué me atacaron? Mariano Martínez donó 13 con 13. Mariano Martínez, es la yeta, Mariano. Cuando sonaba tu donación del número 13, morí. Mariano, es la yeta. Mariano. Mariano, es tu culpa. Te cruzo por la calle y te reviento en la rodilla, Mariano. No te lo puedo creer, Mariano, ¿eh? ¿Dónde carajo estoy? ¡No! ¿Te lo puedo creer? La madre de Jesucristo Nazareno, tan bendito que es él.
Luego continuamos con Pixel Reeves, de Inglaterra, Londres probablemente, cuya presentación es siempre la misma. Dice, hello everyone, my name is Pixel Reeves and welcome back to the Minecraft Survival Guide. I hope you're having a great day. Y bueno, es realmente excelente, tiene unos magníficos videos, algunas granjas donde da crédito a quienes las inventaron, tales como Gnebomb y otros usuarios. Y habla un inglés muy correcto, nunca se le escapa una mala palabra. A pesar de que a veces tiene por ahí demasiado detalle en cuanto a la decoración y construcción.
Hello everyone, my name is PixelRift and welcome back to the Minecraft Survival Guide. I hope you guys are having a good day. We are back here for part 2 of building the Zombie Pigman Golden XP Farm. And as you can see, I've completed the roof and I've completed the floor. I did both of those off camera mainly because I think you guys get the idea. All this is a solid glass floor coming from the bottom of this bottommost platform all the way out to the center here where I've left a 7x7 gap with the corners. And we're probably going to modify this little setup a little bit because right now it is pretty rudimentary. And as before, we have continued the glass around the outside. And people did let me know that you didn't have to use all of this glass. The farm is a little bit see-through and we can watch the guardians come up to the surface. I think I might do that. That's going to need a lot of glass, though. So maybe we'll put a border around with prismarine first, just along the bottom here, and then we'll fill in the rest of it with glass. Because I have a ton of prismarine right now. I'm just bringing it up from the ocean monument as I need it. But this took a lot of oak wood. If you imagine that each fence gate is basically an oak log, because if you take the log, split it into four planks, split two of those planks down into sticks, and you have two planks and four sticks, which is what you need to make a fence gate. So each of these is a stack of fence gates. That constitutes one full stack of oak logs. And then there's 7x7 square of these 8x8 areas. Basically means that, yeah, we had 49, if my math is correct, 49 stacks of oak logs have gone into just making the fence gates for this. So as you can see, this might be a project that you want to scale back a little bit if you're doing it in your own world. Look at the sheer amount of fence gates I have left as well, because I was like, I didn't do the maths beforehand. I just went ahead and made as many fence gates as I could. There we go. We've got some more prismarine bricks in here we can use. Hopefully get Dolphin's Grace along the way. We've got to wait for the mining fatigue effect to kick in here, but then we should be good to go. Okay, there we go. Here it is. Let's give this a try. Now we get splashed by all the potion effects. Looks like all those have kicked in. Okay, we just need to drop ourselves into here, give ourselves that splash potion of regeneration, swim over here, come up and activate the Turtle Master Potion, as well as getting hit by the Shulker's Levitation, which, hello? Yes, okay, great. Now we'll eat the pufferfish, attack ourselves with the glowing spectral arrow, sprint back over here, and eat this blindness. Yes, we did it! We actually did it! Oh my gosh! Yes! Oh, that's so good! Amazing! Man, I couldn't even talk at the end of that. It's just so tense getting this stuff done, but we did it, and oh boy, I'm still taking poison. Look at all the effects. Look at all the effects I have on me right now. And that was probably about half of them, because some of them have such a short duration. All right, well, we did it, folks. I think moving the dolphin next to this whole setup was a very wise move. Like, goodness knows what it's doing right now. I think it's actually been splashed with invisibility. But we got the advancement. Let's open it up. How did we get here? Having every effect applied at the same time. I can't believe we just did that.
Luego tenemos a Mambo Jumbo, que en este caso lo invitan al server SCI, o SciCraft server, que son, es como invitacional únicamente para expertos, y donde le muestran un poco un tour de las granjas y maquinarias increíbles que tienen de gran complejidad, realmente es una locura.
Witch farm to now look utterly pathetic. In fact, I'm embarrassed to even call it a witch farm now.
All right, so it's 500,000 blocks to place, but it actually did it in one day.
Yeah, I was going to say, I mean, how many maps is this? That's
525.
Ahí lo vemos a Il Mango con su skin de conejo muy bonito.
25.
640 by 640 blocks. That's about 420,000, I think.
Wow.
Quick math.
And you had to color code all of this, write out everything. I mean, I'm assuming it's not to scale, but they're kind of suggestions as to where things are.
Yeah, so we kind of got this, the city area in the middle is just all the closer farms.
Yep.
And some of the destinations are up to almost 10,000 blocks away. But yeah, this is not the scale, it's just like a subway map to indicate where everything is.
This is absolutely beautiful. This
and
is
every
so
line
cool.
You see here is a piston bolt here in the network, in the nether, and then of course in the overworld it's 10,000 times 8 away, so even more.
Yeah, wow, okay, so that's pretty serious.
Yeah,
that's
I think mob switch should be off. I'm waiting 5 more seconds and then log out and then we can start the farms.
This is one of the witch farms. I mean, for my baby little witch farm that I'm building on the Hermitcraft server, I'm using this.
Ahí lo vemos a Gnemomb, o Gnemomb, como sea.
As we mentioned while we were over at the train station map in the Nether Hub, this isn't the only witch farm that they've constructed. There's an entire network of them. So it was time to check out all of the other designs that they had. Now, I thought it'd be a good idea to kind of montage this because a lot of the designs are really quite similar. All of them are built in a similar fashion in that you have the two witch huts and then you have these gigantic 16 million block perimeters. 16 million blocks! I mean, it's totally ridiculous to even say that. Once again, to bring it back to my little Hermitcraft witch hut, that's a 1.2 million block perimeter and I thought that was impressive. Coming on here has completely ruined it for me. The thing that I especially like about these things is how much consideration has been taken to make them lag friendly. Obviously all of the bottom subchunks have been filled, all of those stone blocks have been filled in around the witch farm as well to prevent lag, and every single possible consideration that could possibly be made to reduce lag has been made so that they can run farms like this on the server without causing any issues. I just love seeing Minecraft engineering like this.
Mm-hmm. If the items get picked up by the hopper, then a shulker box, which parallelly also gets put through the dropper system, also gets put into that slot, and the items is put back into the shulker box, and that's how we kind of sort filled shulker boxes in this case.
5 million redstone dust can be stored in their system. Impressive. Now, where is this storage system? Well, this, I gotta say, made me laugh. My render distance isn't far enough to actually, like, get this the full impression of this thing. This is totally ridiculous. So is the storage? So the storage system is actually in the base of the witch hut, is it?
Yes.
Yes. Yep.
That's
Wait,
brilliant.
We wasted one witch hut. What is this?
But wait, there's more. The SciCraft guys then found an exploit so powerful and so efficient that even they considered it to be cheaty. This is something that I've got to see. There we go.
Oh, no.
There we go. Oh, there we go.
Fuck at it.
Wait. What? No. This shouldn't exist in Minecraft.
This doesn't make any sense.
I mean technically mobs spawn every tick, yes?
Yeah.
Yeah, and the witches can spawn in the overworld anywhere, pretty where it's dark.
Yep.
Yeah, so this is completely normal.
Yeah, exactly. I've been saying that all the time. No one is listening.
This is completely normal. Could someone explain what exactly is happening here?
Because XCOM, that's your point. Come on, explain.
XCOM.
Okay, I'll explain it very concisely.
Okay. And that's about the right speed as well. That's pretty spot on. And, oh goodness me, yeah, no, it is creating... It's definitely creating infinite water sources as it goes along. Oh no!
Or basically to cover a perimeter or something.
Yep.
So we have a bigger garden farm, I guess, that can deliver a little bit more. So this is an actual map of the actual Minecraft terrain. This is not any...
What happened to it?
you'll see in a moment. Don't worry about it, okay? So the thing with clownfish is up to 1.12. Clownfish was one of the rarest items in the game. And then those shulker boxes, basically those items are being packed to the shulker boxes. Those shulker boxes go to the storage. There is a crafting station where you can craft the items into the blocks. Yep. And then the empty shulker boxes go back to the shulker boxes storage.
This is the most ridiculous thing I think I've ever seen.
And this is not RNG manipulation. This farm actually produces more than the RNG farms produce mobs, like with one.
Wow.
Okay, you can RNG as many spawns as you want, but for one pack, it's actually faster.
This is crazy. I mean, yeah, this is just a constant flow of guardians. I can't believe that this actually exists.
So this is, and this is totally legit. There is nothing that's against any Minecraft rules with regards to this farm.
So that's just brilliant. Sites of stand-in locations. Okay, and that is... Yep.
That is the sand duping or gravity block duping.
Okay.
Now we don't only want the concrete powder, we actually want the concrete as well, right? I mean, you can make a manual machine to mine it, but why not make it automatic? So here we have a concrete factory. It automatically actually makes concrete.
That's so silly. All right, I've got to get a screenshot of this, because it's not going to be able to get across how cool this is. Obviously, they'll be able to see it in the video. This is the coolest thing I think I've seen. This beats the tunnel bore machine.
But this is a double speed one, so it always has two TNT, the basket in the front.
And also levels double. Out the tunnel in the back, too.
Oh, rip immortal.
Wow. This is so
this
interesting.
This machine consists out of, I think, six different parts. So the tunnel bore in the front. Then we spill water to convert lava into obsidian. After that we remove the water again.
Yeah.
Then we create the ice tunnel. Or the ice part.
Then we actually,
We
flatten the bottom in the beginning. Between.
Okay, that could be, yeah. Then we create the ice tunnel, then we slice the ice tunnel, and right in the back, then we also flatten the tunnel, and if you look at the front, how the tunnel looks, and how in the back the tunnel looks, it's insane. So it's completely made automatic. The whole rectangular tunnel with ice pass in the middle and everything.
And it's actually something that I want to use soon, because I've had some interesting ideas with it. Anyway, moving on to another farm.
Yep.
What on earth is this, guys? What on earth is...
Wheat farm.
What are you guys doing? There's no one needs this much wheat.
Well, we bought wheat.
Make blocks out of it.
Yeah, but this is so ridiculous.
Hay bales have the nice property that they absorb fall damage.
Always
a good block to have around.
This is...
Yeah, and when you put a campfire above it, the smoke goes higher.
That one. Then we lure the slimes with iron golems. By now this is quite standard thing, but at the time this was well, not revolutionary, but new, I guess.
Yeah, yeah, it was a new kind of new crimes of being generated by this thing.
Just jumped on.
I mean, that is just so...
jumped out.
Is it at half speed at the moment?
Yes.
That's at half speed.
Why is it at half speed?
No, I fully. No, it's 140 more. Okay.
Okay, good.
That is... This, once again, this could be my screensaver. I definitely want this as my screensaver. This is a
screensaver.
So, I don't know if I've asked, what are the rates of this thing? I have to ask.
About 333.
And where do all those items go? Do they all go in through
that's
the nether?
That's actually an interesting
below.
Basically, we have an item collection system here that packs, basically just first gets all the items in minecart and then unloads them into shulker box loaders.
Yeah.
Those shulker box loaders then pack them into shulker boxes, and then they go through another quality control system like the one we saw on the witch huts. So basically we just detect if the signal strength is 15, and then if it's not 15 they get broken, because sometimes we get feathers or chicken or gold nuggets from zombie pigment that spawn in the portals.
Yeah.
And that that would mess up the crafting system, because the rest of the slime balls get sent to the crafting system, to the little hut you see that enemy is standing on.
Yeah.
And they get placed as shulker boxes there, then you take them out, craft them into slime blocks and put them into this shulker box. And from there, they actually get taken to the top to with an item elevator to a double chest here, and I think somebody who designed the computer should then explain to her.
So
don't need it anymore.
What are the 16.25% and 0.97m? Is that the storage?
So
you're asking the right questions.
Yeah, I'm impressed. So we have at the moment 970,000 slime blocks stored, and that means 16.25% of the storage's capacity is filled up.
Wow.
But so yeah, how do we know this? Automatically. It's the system here next to the arrival hall of the piston bolt.
Yeah.
We store the shulker boxes manually in those double chests here. And then, yeah, we have to go around and check out the computer in the back.
This is... this is quite crazy.
Okay, so this is a fun one. Basically, this whole first bulk part until like somewhere over here, it's just counting all the signal strength together, right?
Right.
So all so-called pull adders. Then basically all that does the U-turn is conversion from hex to decimal.
Right.
Until somewhere over here in the front, and from here on till the display is multiplying by a fixed number, which is the amount of slime blocks per strength.
Right.
And then in the back of that, we see behind those lines here, that's the conversion to percent as well.
Yeah. I mean, look at this thing. It is totally ridiculous. Oh my word. Right, well, I am absolutely chuffed to bits with this thing. To be honest with you, there were many points in this video that I didn't think I was going to be able to pull it off. So I am extremely happy that we have managed to finish this thing. Let me know if you want to see more of these sorts of builds down in the comments section. I'm now interested in working on some other potentially quite cool designs. How fast can you travel in Minecraft? It's a question that I asked way back in 2015 when, let's face it, times were simpler. There were far fewer ways to travel quickly in Minecraft, so the selection was fairly small.
Y también tenemos a Il Mango, entre otros, miembro del server SCI Craft o SciCraft, donde en uno de sus videos hace una especie de tour por varias de sus granjas que tienen, que me imagino que son tan grandes que no cargan los chums estando uno en un punto estático, así que tienen que hacer esos recorridos en rieles de cientos de kilómetros, lo cual llega a ser una locura, un mantra, no sé cómo quieran llamarlo. Te sirve para dormir realmente, escuchar el ruido ese tan fantástico de los pistones. Un poquito aburrido, pero realmente muy interesante, muy divertido también por otro punto de vista. Realmente magnífico.